You see, this is what happened when you leave front door open. A Boris will come and eat your семечки.
That's good.
Блин, that was the dustiest семечки ever.
Сам Небор Вадим, what have you been cooking here? I thought guest stove was forbidden in this house. What is this now? Oh, some new kind of vodka you have here. This is apple juice. I feel betrayed just a bit. Вадим, блять!
Yes, Boris!
So, let's see. What else does he have we can make food of? Bread and lemon, what kind of new cooking diet is this? Wait, let me check fridge. Well, we have some good news and some not so very great news. The bad news is that now I know that Vadim has same cups as me. And also the cheap bastards has not invested in cooking balls, so this will have to do. Actually, wait, this looks exactly like mine. Anyway, after going through Vadim's poorly stocked fridge, I realized he has just enough stuff to make some сырник. Mega point of which is cheese. That does not really look like cheese. It just sounds exactly like... if done correctly. Add about half a kilogram of that and have a nice big sip of Vadim's fake vodka. Next up, add in 2 units of chicken produced and just about a half a ton of sugar. If you actually really want to make this yourself, then there will be scientifically accurate measurement of all components in description. This unmentionable white powder is flour, hopefully, and another different white powder this time. Package might say vanilla sugar, but in Vadim's case I can only hope it's not red poison. Also add just a bit of salt. And cooking oil, so it would not be as dry as Vadim's семечки. And as if there was not enough fat already inside, add a nice brick of butter as well. Mix together everything that you have added, and pray to whatever higher being you believe in, that you added soft butter instead of hard. Unless you're strong slightly, no matter. So, consistency that you're looking for, think alien brain versus blender. If you are happy with your blended alien brain, move over to your stove and better make sure that it's a live fire one. Дай, блядь! Okay, everybody happy, let's move on. Moisten your pan with the appropriate lubricant and slap on a few moist nuggets of that mix you made. The mission objective of Comrade Сырник is to be as thick as possible. Shit, that can't be good. So by now I guess you are seeing the similarity to some of the smaller blends that I have made. A Сырник, or a Чизник as one of my good Russian friends calls it, is essentially cottage cheese pancake. Come on, what else do you need? So you can flip these units with your... wooden spoon, or you can go full копник. Опа! But not exactly good enough. Ой, пиздец! Вадим will clean it up. If you mess up your сырники, and they end up as dark as the night sky, then feel free to offer some to your neighbors. Wait, shit, I am the neighbor. So what I'm saying is, you get best result when you cook them on low heat. And I mean really low. You could not even warm up your afternoon tea with this. But it's good enough for this сырник. You see this? Light brown. Even golden brown. You just want to eat them. You scoop out the ones that you did not burn and serve them with sour cream. A lot of sour cream. Or if your name is Boris, of course you go for mayonnaise. Or let me ask you this. Do you have access to докторская колбаса or doctor sausage? Slap it on with a slice of cheese. And boom, there you go. Full meal. Or let's say you just want to leave a questionable gift to your neighbor Vadim. You take those dark black сырниks and you cover it all with sweetened condensed milk. Well, thank you for watching, my friends. Stay cheeky-breaky, and I will see you... Но пиздец.
Блин, it's good thing Vadim live on second floor.
Stay cheeky-breaky, my friends. I'll see you next time.